This is
Jeffrey Barchin, professor of art history at the Graduate Center of the City University of New York and author of famous books on photography, gave a lecture on history of photography at the Photographers Gallery located in Oxford Street, Central London. G. Barchin analyzed photography as a medium and reviewed the historical origins of photography. He went through invention and evolution of photographic process in the 19th century, from portraits and paintings through Photoshop today. He showed first impressive photographs in history that are displayed in museums today as the origins of the media. This video, inspired by Barchin's lecture, is about the stages of photographic practices. Its earliest experimenters, Henry Talbot, Beard Richard, and Antoine Claudette, they helped improve and get us having a camera, enabling us to erase and retouch our pictures in the 21st century. Fox Talbot made a major contribution to the photographic process. His ambition into improving the process of photography led him to a new machine with light-sensitive paper. Fox Talbot went on to develop the three primary elements of photography: developing, fixing, and printing. Although simply exposing photographic paper to the light produced an image, it required extremely long exposure time. By accident, he discovered that there was an image after a very short exposure. Although he could not see it, he found he could chemically develop it into a useful negative. With the negative image, Fox Talbot realized he could repeat the process of printing from the negative. Consequently, his process could make any number of positive prints. He was rewarded with a medal from the Royal Society for his work in 1832. His pictures show a measure of artistic taste. Talbot attempted to produce sketches from the Lake of Como in Italy with the aid of both a camera obscura and a camera lucida. The earliest surviving paper negative is of the now famous Oriel window in the Salt Gallery at Lacock Abbey. Talbot called his improved version the kalotype, meaning beautiful in Greek. In 1844, Talbot published a book entitled The Pencil of Nature. Richard Beard was Britain's first portrait photographer, who helped to establish professional photography in the UK. With the first professional portrait studio in England officially opened in March 1841, this studio was on the roof of the Polytechnic Institution in Regent Street, London, now the University of Westminster, and John Goddard, a science lecturer, was Beard's operator. At the time, the portrait would cost the sitter between 1 and 4 guineas. Exposure would be from 3 seconds to as much as 5 minutes, depending upon the weather. There was much money to be made from portraits. Beard used to advise those who sat for portraits to avoid white as much as possible. The best kind of dress to wear on such occasions is any material upon which there is a play of light and shade. Beard's business was very successful, and at one stage, he was reputed to be earning £125 a day. Though Beard was describing himself in 1851 as a photographic artist and exhibited at the Great Exhibition, there's little evidence that he was himself an extensive practitioner. It was his rival Claudette who gained royal recognition. Antoine Claudette was a French photographer and artist, student of Louis Daguerre. He was one of the first to practice daguerreotype portraiture in England, and he improved the sensitizing process by using chlorine in addition to iodine, thus gaining greater rapidity of action. He also invented the red, safe darkroom light, and he was he who suggested the idea of using a series of photographs to create the illusion of movement. The idea of using painted backdrops is also attributed to him. From 1841 to 1851, he operated a studio on the roof of the Adelaide Gallery behind St. Martin's in the Fields Church, London. He opened subsequent studios in Regent's Park and Regent Street, where he established what he called a temple to photography. In 1848, he produced the photographometer, an instrument designed to measure the intensity of photogenic rays, and in 1849, he brought out the focimeter for securing the perfect focus in photographic portraiture. He was elected a fellow of the Royal Society in 1853. Claudette received honors in 1853 as Photography in Ordinary to Queen Victoria.